Hello and welcome back to the Digital Health and Wearables series. Today I have another magnificent episode and leader for you. But before I go ahead, let me remind you to subscribe to the channel and also share this content with your communities in health and healthcare. Also, let me acknowledge our partners, the digital health platform Clinitouch V and our industry partner, Isaac Care. Today gives me great pleasure to introduce you to Kelly Benning. She is a digital health executive and vice president at LiveMetric. Kelly, how are you?
I'm good. How are you, João? Nice to be here today.
Brilliant. Thank you so much for accepting my invite.
Yeah, thank you for having me. I am excited to talk to you. You're the expert in the wearable space, so I'm looking forward to hearing what you have to say and having this conversation with you.
Brilliant. I've been following your work and the development of LiveMetric. You know, I'm always like trying to follow the best companies and everything. So I'm excited about also your progression. And today the title of the topic of the conversation is the epidemic of hypertension. And I'm going to go straight to the questions. Is that okay?
That's fine. Thanks.
So the first question that I have for you, Kelly, is why is LiveMetric addressing hypertension?
This is something that I think is not very well known. And hypertension is actually mankind's largest epidemic. It leads to the number one killer of stroke and heart attack and is responsible for more deaths than any other condition. And what we've seen recently, especially with COVID, is that there's an exponential need to monitor users and patients and members outside of the hospital because they're currently not coming into the office because of COVID, or they didn't come in for 2 years because of COVID. They weren't monitored, and so their blood pressure might be uncontrolled, or they might have newly identified blood pressure that they're unaware of, or maybe they stopped taking their medication during this two-year period. So not only did we have an epidemic coming into it, but now we have even more of what we're seeing with the issues related to hypertension because of COVID. And so we decided as a company that one of the things we could do with big data was to try to combat the largest epidemic there is, and that is hypertension.
Brilliant. Certainly the pandemic, I mean, highlighted a lot of the things that we could have done better in digital health, but also increase is kind of a paradox, but also increase the risk of other diseases too, because people stay at home, more mental health issues, worries about their personal lives, and also illness directly. But yeah, and hypertension is such a big problem, and you are right, not really well publicized, if you like.
It is not well publicized, and it's also a symptomless disease. It's not like diabetes where you would feel physically ill if your blood sugar was not managed. Hypertension can take years and years and years, and usually is at the end stages before you feel any of the impact of it. But during that time, you're at risk of cardiovascular disease and at risk of events like heart attack and stroke. And so there really does need to be more education around it. But more importantly, there needs to be more data. And we're really excited about the level of data, the big data that we're going to bring to hypertension, both to the provider and the patients in that sense, because that's what's going to take to fight this.
Brilliant. Thank you, Kelly. And certainly, you know, I'm an advocate of wearables. Certainly, wearables are the perfect vehicle to gather and collect that data. So the second question that I have for you is, how is LiveMetric different from another cuff monitor?
Yeah. This question, I'll try not to go too long because there's a lot I could say, but I think there's some really important points here. And one of the most important points is that a cuff or a PPG sensor measures blood flow. And so you get a nice estimation of pressure. And what LiveMetric does is we use mechanical sensors that measure actual pressure. So we are the only device on the market that's highly correlated to the arterial line. The arterial line is actually inserted into your artery. It has a mechanical sensor that measures pressure, and we're highly correlated to that, which means we're as accurate as an arterial line used in the ICU. So by doing this, what we've done is made it available for a provider to know that the readings that are happening outside of the hospital are accurate. He doesn't need to bring that patient back in, or she doesn't need to bring that patient back in to check them to make sure that the readings that they had were actually accurate. They can rely on these readings from anywhere at any time. And so that's one major difference. The second major difference is that LiveMetric is worn passively as a wrist-worn bracelet, if you will. And that means that you don't have to pump up a cuff. It's not tight. It doesn't hurt. And you don't have to necessarily do all of the steps that you have to take to put on a cuff and take a measurement with LiveMetric. You can wear the band at all times and be able to receive monitoring and measurements while you're wearing it, even while asleep. So that's probably the third biggest difference, is that people can't measure their blood pressure at night while they're asleep. Or they could, but they would have to wake up. So with LiveMetric, you can take measurements overnight while you're asleep. And for the first time, doctors will have data and patients will have data about their nighttime monitoring. And what we can see with the nighttime monitoring are things like morning surge. Are they dipping, not dipping, reverse dipping with their blood pressure? All of these indicators of cardiovascular disease that we're bringing to the market for the first time. So that's really exciting. And then the last point I'll make is that we have a very quality signal with our sensors. And so we collect the full pressure waveform at 100 hertz. And by collecting that full pressure waveform, we're actually able to see how a medication works, each heartbeat, against blood pressure. We're able to see the potential of disease states like biphasic systole and other conditions that that you would normally only see if you had an ECG, an echocardiogram, or labs done. So we're super excited about the future of LiveMetric in this collection of the full pressure waveform and what we believe and know that we can see with it.
Yeah, brilliant. Thank you, Kelly. I mean, it's certainly, like, as you well know, one of the issues with wearables is the reliability, the accuracy, and the impact in the first place. But, you know, so it seems like you have, of course, very advanced technology, but you are on the right track to really, I mean, gather the right data and the reliable data, which is so, so important.
Thank you.
Yeah, the third and last question that I have for you, Kelly, is what's the real value of using your advanced wearable in the concept of passive monitoring made more accessible?
Yeah. Well, as I mentioned before, the blood pressure cuff, some people don't like to use it because it's painful and it's a process. And you have to manually record your data and take that into your provider. By wearing our device passively, that data can be electronically transmitted to your doctor, so you know you're being monitored at all times. But in addition to that, you're able to really better understand how your lifestyle and behavior impacts your blood pressure, as well as your medications. So if you decide not to take your medications, let's say, which happens with blood pressure, and you don't take it for a week, well, as you're passively wearing the monitor, you're going to see over that week's time, the band is going to show you that your blood pressure might be going up. Or if you eat really high salt meals for a month, you might see your blood pressure going up. These kinds of things that just aren't accessible with a cuff. Because a cuff you put on, you might get two or three spot measurements per day, but because our band is passive, you can wear it night and day all the time and receive hundreds or thousands of measurements. And through those hundreds or thousands of measurements, you're really able to look at your trends in your blood pressure. You're able to see where the outliers are. You're able to see things like blood pressure variability. All of these data points, these big data points that are backed by machine learning algorithms, really give you a better insight into your disease management and treatment, as well as what you might be at risk for of developing. And so it's through this passive wearing, though, is the only way to really get these hundreds or thousands of measurements that you want, because you want to see your trends over time. Having a few passive blood pressure measurements per day that are static from a cuff it's helpful, but it's not that helpful. So we believe that through the passive wearing it and the collection of so much data, that it's going to really revolutionize the ability to titrate medications faster, to find those uncontrolled patients faster, and to do a lot of things that just aren't possible right now with a blood pressure cuff.
That's brilliant. Fantastic. What a nice way to round off and to finish, Kelly. Kelly, I come up to the end of the interview. I mean, thanks for this magnificent insight. I'm not sure if you've seen it, but I finish all my episodes in a peculiar way. It's not really a question. It's a bit of a surprise. It's called 1 minute of fame. You can talk about anything whatsoever. Life metric, shout out, personal life, any of your interests, anything whatsoever. To round up, over to you, 1 minute of fame.
Okay. Well, I think it might be interesting to talk about the FDA, because we just received FDA clearance. And for startup companies and wearable companies, I think I would just like to share that the path is not always straight and the path is not always easy. But I can't really explain, when you have that FDA clearance and you know that you're going to market, the feeling of all the hard work that comes to fruition, and knowing that what you're doing could really impact population and health on a population level, is just absolutely incredible. And so I think I would just bring up that for the next minute, talking about what you do as a startup and why it matters, because I know there's some days where you just feel like throwing in the towel, but that's definitely, we need all the startups. We need them all. and we want them to stay in the game.
Brilliant. Kelly, thank you so much for accepting. Congratulations. That's a big step forward, as you know. The hard work, it's not an easy journey. I appreciate that. Thank you so much for your work, your input, and also these magnificent insights. And I wish you all the best going forward.
Thank you so much. And thank you for your show and bringing this information to the community. I think it's really important. And I think as we watch wearables grow, platforms like yours will just become even more important as people look for resources to better understand how they can manage their health. So thank you for what you do.
Brilliant. Thank you, Kelly. I'm going to round up now. To all our viewers and listeners, make sure you subscribe to the channel. Also, I'm going to put Kelly's details in here, social media, LinkedIn and Twitter. Follow her great work, and of course, LiveMetric. And let me finally remind you to subscribe to the channel. Also acknowledge our digital health platform, Clinitouch V, and our industry partner, Isaac Care. And I'll see you all next week.